Today I wanted to talk about something a bit more structured and applicable to life in the immediate future. So if we think about or begin to explore the idea of being grounded in your own knowing, when I say grounded in your own knowing, it is a sense of you knowing your next move, knowing what feels right, knowing exactly what it is or where you should be, and knowing the next step, and exactly what it is that you should be doing. In order to achieve this, there is an element of needing to trust in yourself. In order to be able to trust in yourself, there needs to be a love of oneself. This is what I mean when I say about being structured today. It's like a series of steps in order for you to reach the point of not only knowing, but reach the point of trusting your knowing. And this is something that I suppose you may hear and you may not fully grasp or understand and may want to. So the idea of this video is to show you the steps that are required for you to reach that point where you can actually get it and understand what it is. When we talk about knowing and we talk about your sense of things, another person might be very sensual and sensory, and they might pick up on their knowing very quickly and their intuition. So for those that want to get to that place of grounding in your knowing, these are some steps that you can take. Firstly, there is the self-love aspect, which is if you love all of yourself, you will, I suppose, be nice to yourself. If you're nice to yourself, the part of you that has the information, the part of you that contains the knowing, and this golden nugget of treasure, really, will be revealed to you, because that person is very quiet when you are in a state that you don't like yourself or aren't nice to yourself. If you criticize yourself or judge yourself or make yourself wrong for anything, this part will not show itself to you. In order for this part to feel free to emerge, there is a huge aspect to you needing to love yourself and be very gentle with yourself in order for that part to feel that it is okay to come out. And when it emerges, there's another level of care and self-love that is required for it to even speak. So there is a huge element of the gentle hand and being very nice to yourself, being very acknowledging of yourself in all of these steps, and encouraging of yourself, inspiring confidence therefore in yourself and belief in yourself. The self-love part is a huge aspect of this, okay? So loving yourself, encouraging that part to come forth. Supporting oneself after that, so supporting that beacon of light that has emerged. This part has a trove of information for you, you know, as to where you should go in terms of direction, as to where you should be, as to your capacity to have a knowing of yourself in general, really, yourself in totality, and also any questions that you have about what you should do or how you should be or where you should go, whether it's career, relationship, anything else, friendships, day to day, courses, any questions you have, really, the answers are contained within yourself. And that is the main point of today's video, is that you have all the answers. In order for you to really believe that you have the answers, so that you can hear them, there needs to be a huge element of, first of all, self-love. There needs to be self-support in yourself. With that, you will become able to trust yourself and trust your inner knowing. That if you have a sense of something, if you walk in somewhere, you have a sense of it, energetically, you'll go with that sense. That you won't question it, you won't look for confirmation, you won't look for a second opinion. You will believe in yourself totally. And what this does is this enforces or this invites you to be able to be independent and not require yourself or any part of yourself to be dependent on another. And in terms of therapy and psychotherapy, this is something that is developed within the room. This is something that is brought out of the other person so that the client can build up their own support and their own self-love and their own ability to have trust in their inner knowing and can then move through life without requiring something else to be dependent on or somebody else to be dependent on. They now have a full sense of self. And that inner knowing will always be with you because it's always contained within yourself, inside of yourself. It is just, I suppose, a journey of accessing that part of yourself and then minding it to keep it breathing, to keep it alive, and being quiet enough and gentle enough and nice enough to yourself that you can hear it when it speaks. So for today, I would just like to leave you with that. The steps to reaching or hearing, I should say, your inner knowing. If you'd like to email me on thegoodtherapyroom@gmail.com or louise@thegoodtherapist.com. I also do one-on-one sessions online or in person, and I'm based here in Reykjavik at present. Any questions, any comments, please use them below, and I'd love to hear from you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.